Ladies and gentlemen, with me now, a man who is most familiar to kids that get in trouble in Cook County, Judge William Sylvester White, Chief Judge of the Juvenile Division of our County Circuit Court and President of the prestigious National Association of Juvenile and Family Court Judges. Judge, what did you think of the film?
Not much.
What was wrong with it in your eyes?
I'm afraid it's going to create a public mischief. It's going to create the idea that there's a simplistic solution to juvenile crime. And wonder of wonders, it's not going to cost the taxpayer anything. And those are just not the facts.
What are the
facts? If it is true that a visit to prison will scare people straight, why is it that for the 17-year-olds and 18-year-olds who go to prison for terms are not scared straight, but rather return again and again? If the principles behind this film are true, that on a broad basis, you can scare people into behaving, then everything I've learned about people in all these years is untrue. Now, I must say that with this caveat. Some things will work with some people sometime, and perhaps there are some children that this might work with, but I want the public to know it's no panacea for juvenile crime. And I'm afraid it might give that impression. Further, I doubt whether it would have any such effect on the broad spectrum of kids. I think in the film they said only 1 out of 17 went wrong. Well, those statistics are even better than ours. And there was something else I didn't like about the film. It carries with it, it seems to me, the inference that we who are in juvenile justice have no programs which do work. The contrary is true. We do have programs and we have scientific proof of their effectiveness. Not with every kid, and you're not going to get any program that will be effective with every kid. But I've talked too much. You asked me one question and I almost took up a half hour.
Do you think a program like Scared Straight could be beneficial to some kids? Maybe the ones that the other successful programs don't work on. Is there a place for it in our system?
The returns are yet not in. I noticed they had followed the pilot group that were in the film for what, 1 year?
3 months in that
3 months.
Year.
Well, if it's 3 months, that's even less. But I would wait, I would approach this with caution before I would, for example, sentence people to go see Scared Straight or to participate in Scared Straight. I have grave doubts about programs like that, like sending drivers to driver's school and have them look at horrible pictures.
Doesn't make sense to you. We were talking a little bit earlier today about why there's such a great emphasis on fear, and you had an interesting little story about France.
Oh, yes, and you know the story about they used to have public guillotine in France, where they would execute people guilty of picking pockets. And as the crowds looked at the guillotine and the execution, a pickpocket would be going around through the crowds picking pockets when he sees right up there another pickpocket being executed for those acts. I really don't think that fear is a very good tool to use in creating lawful behavior.
When you sentence somebody, how do you do it? How do you determine what they need the most?
Well, first, I have the benefit of a whole lot of analysis of the child. I have much of his history before me. But even armed with that, it's a little like playing God because you're trying to predict what another human being will do. And even after he's been examined by a psychiatrist and our social workers have had the social history, it still is a puzzle sometime as to why Johnny is doing so poorly and his brother, a few years younger or older, living in the same family with the same environment, is not getting into trouble. So it's a little like playing God, as I say.
Does it ever bother you, the kind of work that you do, because of that?
No, I feel as though somebody must do it, and I give it my best shot. And so, no, it doesn't bother me.
what do you think is a major problem in rehabilitating kids that go wrong? Do we have enough programs? Are we putting enough emphasis on rehabilitation? Or are we fostering further problems by virtue of the system?
I think that one of the better things that we need more is more cooperation among the agencies charged with doing something for children.
Mm-hmm.
I think if there were more cooperation among the schools, the courts, mental health, I think we could do a better job.
Is there a common ground in kids that go wrong? Do they have anything, any indication early on in life? You said you can't tell why somebody goes wrong in a family, but is there a certain group of kids that has problems?
Well, if you would come through our court, you could look around and you would see that the inner city is overrepresented. And I don't think that's because there's anything peculiar about inner city people, but it's the social conditions under which they live. But we can't wait for the millennium to come when everybody will get the full dinner pail and the kind of social environment we would wish that they could have. Meanwhile, we have to use our very best tools. And I'd like for you to know, and I'd like for your viewers to know, that although the tools used by the juvenile court at times appear too benign, they are probably more effective than the tools used in the adult court. We took a sample of some 600 kids accused of serious crimes.
Robbery, armed, murder,
yeah, and so forth.
Things like that?
I don't know whether there was a murder in the group or not. And we traced them through our system. And in a 3-year period, there was a recidivism rate of 14%. What's that, 1 out of 7? Now, that means that 1 out of 7 we did not reach, but we reached the other 6. At least he stayed straight for 3 years, not just like 1 year in the Rahway prison picture.
What are some of the things that you do to rehabilitate kids? You said you have a lot of successful programs. I'm not familiar with any of them. I've never been involved.
We do everything, but from probation officer trying to get a kid a job to family therapy, if it's a matter of family breakdown. We have recently started even a Boy Scout program for juvenile felons. It is not underway yet, and one of the papers correctly observed that we want to make sure this is effective, because to answer wrongdoing with something as nice as the Boy Scouts doesn't seem to be our way of justice. And we do hope it will turn out all right. We realize that we are on the spot, and we're going to keep them very under strict discipline. These are children, but for some strong program, they would be going to the Department of Corrections. The genius of the program, if it has any, will be we'll give the child more coverage. He'll be in school right after school every day. He has to go to his Boy Scout meeting. On weekends, he's taken out of the neighborhood, out into the wilderness. And we think with this kind of coverage, once again, though, even for something this good, it wouldn't work with everybody. But it will work with some, and we hope that with the expertise we have, we can tell which program for which kid.
Okay, what we need then, according to you, is an individualized approach to juvenile crime. With less emphasis on fear and more of an emphasis on teaching them to do something with their lives that is productive, getting them jobs, getting them interested in their neighborhood. Is that right?
Yes, and I think we who are in the child care or juvenile justice field ought to probably zero in on the children who most need our help. If a child truants from school and he goes over in Jackson Park and fishes every day, doesn't want to go to school, I wonder how much of the system's energy ought to go to that child. Maybe that's the thing for his parents to take care of, and I don't know to what extent they ought to lean on the courts to make Johnny go to school.
That's one of the things we'll have to look at a little later. We're out of time. Judge, thank you so much for coming in. Whether or not we should have a scared straight program in Illinois is still a subject for debate. Whether we will depends on the outcome of an effectiveness study being conducted by Southern Illinois University. But your input is essential. If you have an opinion, write to us here at Channel 32. Send your letters to Scared Straight, WFLD-TV, 300 North State, Chicago. Remember, that's Scared Straight, WFLD-TV, 300 North State, Chicago, 60610. And we'll pass it along to the proper authorities. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Kathy McFarland. Good night.